Good day, everyone. I want to sincerely appreciate the Chancellor and the Fathers for this great, amazing privilege that I have today. Thank you so much, sir. It's a very beautiful day, and I'm sure we're going to learn a lot today. I'm very positive about it. We're going to talk about something very interesting today, which is time management and resource management. Now, like he said, my name is Gift Mathias, and for over 4 to 6 years, I've been in the pursuit for what would differentiate an individual from being average and becoming excellent. I've had it at the back of my mind that we have people that are struggling in this economy today, but we also have those people that are doing exceptionally well. What is that one thing that the people below has and the people above also have? What is that one thing that will differentiate us from where we are today, from where we want to be? We have high value individuals in Nigeria today across the world. I've had it in mind to speak to millionaires. I've hosted them on podcasts. I've interviewed them. I've interviewed even one billionaire. I've had a lot of time reading books and making my own personal research. What is that one thing somebody have that I can look into today that would differentiate an average man from an excellent man? And there's one thing that's cut across these different individuals that I've had in contact with, and it's time management. Aside money, the next thing you can spend is what? Is what? That is to say, time equals money. So if you can spend money, you can also spend time. So if you can waste money, that also means you can waste time. Today we're going to talk about something very interesting that would change our lives drastically, that if you implement these strategies, this idea about time management, from where you are today, in a couple of months, 2024 will be one of the best years you'll remember. The first and the most important anchor, the first and the most important strategy, the first and the most important goal, the first and the most important idea that you should think about is your goal. Rule number one for time management is, what is your goal? What is your goal? What do I want to achieve in 2024? We have 6 more months to end the year. We've lost 6 already, so we have 6 more. What do I want to achieve? If you want to manage your time, you should be able to distinctively determine how your goal is. When I look back at 2024, what should be at the back of my mind? 2020 has passed, 2021, 22, 23, and this is 2024. My business is the same. Your finance is the same. Your family is the same. To manage your time carefully, you have to ask yourself, what is my goal? Write it down clearly. Now, to write down your goal or to figure out what your goal is, there's a beautiful strategy. Every goal has 3 elements. The first element is your personal goal. What are your personal goals? What do I want to achieve in this year? The second element is, what is my financial goal? How much are you earning now? If you're earning 50,000, I want to earn 100,000 by the end of this year. Every single month, that is your financial goal. I want to start up a beautiful business aside the one I have now. When I first, my first business, it failed. I had my second business, it also failed. And I found out something from a man. I met one man in Abuja and I asked him, I said, sir, I've started some businesses over the years, but they failed drastically while I was in school, while I left school. And he asked me one question. He said, Gift, what are your goals for this year? And I said, I have no goal at the moment. And he said, if you don't have any goal at the moment, I can distinctively guess how much you have in your bank account. The amount of goals you have is directly proportional to how much finance you can also have. The first element of your goal is your personal. The second is your finance, your business. And the third is your self-development goals. How many books do you want to read? I personally read a book every single week. That is 60 pages every day. If you want to be exceptional, you must do something others are not doing. That is the rule of life. You want to manage your time clearly, do not have time for other things. We're going to talk about it. And the last thing, which I said, is your self-development goals. What do I want to know more? My mentor told me, if you learn more, you will earn more. It's a simple philosophy. If you earn more, that means you're learning more. Write down your goal clearly. These are the things I want to do before the end of this year. The second and the most important principle of time management is what I call your pivot of ideas. That is your plan. Now, we look at your goal as the destination. Your goal is what? The destination. Your plan is basically what takes you from where you are to that destination. All right, I want to be able to make 200,000 naira every month aside from what I earn as a worker, right? That is your goal. Now, what is our plan to get that goal? I told my mentor one day, I said, I want to be able to sell 5,000 books. I want to be able to sell 100 books. And he said, that is your goal. So what is the plan? Write down your plan clearly. Your plan should be in clear terms listed. I'm going to tell you one strategy I use to list my plan. I call it the A, the B, the C, the D, and the E. The first, which is your A plan, is what are those things that I must do today? What are those things that will clearly influence my goal? What are those things that if I don't do them, I am just going to head towards mediocrity? That is your A. Write down those things, your goal, put it in that format, your A things. Now the B is what are those things I should do? That means if I have spare time, it would be nice for me to do them. Your C are also those things. Then your D are those things you must delegate. Delegate somebody to do those things. And your E, you have to eliminate them. My mentor also told me, you either change the plan or you change the goal. Have a look at your booklet today if you are writing. Write down those things. I want to be closer to my family. I want to spend time with my children. I want to spend time in church. I want to spend time with my family members. Those are your goals. What plans do you want to have for that things? List them down. They should be in clear terms listed. One of the fundamentals for self-development is clarity. He also told me, he said, if you forget where you're going to, don't forget where you're coming from. Most of us seated here today, we have very vague goals. We have very vague mindsets. We don't have clarity. I want to make money. No. That is not clear. How much money do you want to make? When do you want to make that money? And how? How do you want to make it? Right? I realize that some of us here are working about 4 times in a week. That means we have about 3 days every week that is free. If you're working once in a week, that means you have like Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. If you do 3 times 52, you know you have a lot of time to work on any business. You don't need spare time again. You need clear goals. One of the time I was speaking to one of my mentors and I asked him, I said, I'm really working a 9-to-5 and I'm stressed. I have a lot going on. I need breaks. And he said, how much break do you need more? You have Saturday, you have Sunday. You have like 2 more days in the week because you're working just 3 times in a week. That means you have 4 days out of the week to work on anything that you want to do. The first point I made was your goal. The second I made was your plan. The third, which is one of the most important, is your clear priorities. What are those things that are topmost priority for you? What are those things that are much more important than any other thing? It is clear you know that, like we said, time waits for no man. If you don't get to do your priorities by the end of this year, the next year will come and you'd have wasted time. What are your priorities? That's why I told you in Clayton, list them down. I want to do this and I want to do this clearly. Now, number 4, which is also very important, is concentration. Putting enough effort to that thing you want to do. One of my mentors told me, he said, if you don't put in enough concentration, you will not bend the learning curve. Now it takes you doing things over and over and over and over again to get good at it. That is to say, when you set out time to do a particular thing, get it done. You have your priority list. What are the major things and the minor things you have to focus on? Focus, concentrate on that thing that has the more percentage growth. A wise man named Pareto has a principle he called the 80-20 rule. He says that the 80% of the results, whatever you want to do, is concentrated in the 20% of that effort. That means if you have a list of 10 things, 2 out of those 10 are the most important. I want to start a palm oil business. I want to start a clothing business. Your thought is just 80%. The most important is taking your phone and calling somebody that is in that business already. You thinking about it has no role to play. It will lead to the fifth or the sixth point, procrastination. If you want to manage your time effectively in 2024, you must fight one thing, procrastination. A wise man once said, there are two types of procrastination. There's the negative and the positive procrastination. Now, those minor things, when you shift them aside, those things are called the positive procrastination. I want to read one book every week. I want to learn from my particular field. I want to be very good with sales. I want to be very good with marketing. I want to be very good in the digital space. And I have a list. My D, which is the things I can delegate or the things I should do, are the minor things. I'll focus more on the major things. Procrastination has killed more people than AIDS and even malaria. Some people ask me, how did you know? It's clear. If the person you can become is not made manifest till you die, you're as good as dead, even if you're alive. There's a potential in everybody seated, but there's one thing you have to fight effectively, is procrastination. If you can do it later, you can do it now. If you can do it tomorrow, why not do it now? That call you need to make tomorrow, you can make it now. Because as you're wasting time, you're also wasting money. One wise man once said, he said, if you're not making a particular amount of money, you are paying for that. So, if my vision is to make $10,000 every single month, that is about 14 million naira, right? And I'm making 1 million naira every month. You know how much I'm paying? I'm paying 13 million naira in time for not making that 14 million naira I want to make every month. Most of us sitting here today are workers. Most of us here have the idea of starting up a business in the future. One thing that will fight you to your grave if you don't make actions now is procrastination. One of the principles that has changed my life completely is rule number 7. Rule number 7 is set deadlines and reward. You have to set deadline and reward. You must set deadline and reward. Most of us as workers, one of the reasons we are motivated to work or to come is because we know at the end of 30 days, there's a deadline, you'll be paid. So treat your free time with deadlines. Treat your free time, your side business, treat it with what? With deadlines and reward. One of the most difficult things most people do today is to have time for themselves. You are diligent to come to the office every day for 3 days or 4 days in a week. You cannot be diligent to take up that book, to make that call, to reach out to that family and friend for the remaining 3 days of the week. Why? Because subconsciously, there's no reward for you. You think, if I actually put in effort to grow my business, what is the reward? The reward might not be clear now, but trust me, it will be clear in the future. Set out deadlines, it is very important. A philosopher once said a law, he called it the Parkinson law. He says that work fill out time allocated for it. So if you say, I'll wash my clothes in 5 hours, you would wash that clothes in 5 hours. If you say, maybe something happened during that 5 hours, and you had to wash it in 1 hour, you would also wash it in 1 hour. If you set out too long, it will take you forever. If you set out immediate, it will take you now. One of the most important traits of every successful man, Elon Musk, Bill Gates, Warren Buffett, is urgency. You must be urgent. You must be urgent. There's a universal principle that says when one idea comes to a man, it also goes to 100 men. That one business you want to start, if you don't start it now, tomorrow you look around, somebody close to you is doing it. Be urgent. Be urgent. Treat it like you don't have any other time, because urgency is very, very important. The next thing I said was reward. When you pick your goal and the plan, reward yourself for it. For me personally, if I said, okay, I'll make 10 calls every day, I'll call potential clients, because I'm working as an on-air personality for a radio station, so I have my spare time to work on my side business. So if I said I was going to make 10 calls every single day, at the end of that 10 call, I owe myself something. It could be a bottle of water. It could be 2 minutes with my phone. It could be 10 seconds with your phone. Talking about phone, the eighth principle for time management is your phone management and meetings. One of the greatest distractions of mankind today is technology. If you don't manage your phone will manage you. And over time, you will lose interest. So, when I was thinking about it, I said, how can I manage my phone as a business owner, as a worker? How can I manage my gadgets? How can I manage WhatsApp? How can I manage Instagram? The first principle that came to my mind is create and don't consume. Any social media platform you are today, either as an individual or as a business owner, create more than you consume on that platform. We as humans, we are made to create, to also procreate. You must create. There's no other form of satisfaction that comes rather than creation. You can't manage your time anyhow if you don't create. Time will what? Be gone. The second principle is to get on and get off as quick as possible. Treat your phone as a parcel. Be done as soon as possible. Aside very close relative, when you call me after the pleasantries, the next question I ask you is, how can I help you? We want to manage our time clearly. How can I help you? There's no time for excessive gist. We have only 6 more months to ensure that we don't look back on 2024 as every other year. The management has made it possible that we would be able to work 4 times, you can work 3 times. That means you also have more time to work on your business. So that little time you have to work on your business, you have to utilize it clearly. Hello, gifts. How are you doing today? I'm fine. How can I help you? Oh, I just called to say hi. I'm doing very well. Have a great day. The third principle of telephone management in time management is to have a note before you make a call. Before I make any single call, I must have a sticky note or a piece of paper and a pen. My mentor once told me, he said, no matter how fainted a pen or a book is, it's much more trusted than any other thing. A piece of paper, a pen. Before I hop on a call, I'll write down the agenda. I called you to inform you that I'll be at this meeting by 10 o'clock. Will you be there? Yes, I'll be there. All right, I'll be sending you this amount of money by this time. I write it down because your brain cannot be trusted as much as a piece of paper. One of the things that made me lose money when I started my first business was the fact that somebody somewhere said we had a deal and the person had a piece of paper that I did not. I can't counter the person. Hop on your phone, get off, and have a booklet, a piece of paper. It will do you very much in building your business aside. I've tried my possible best to ensure that I grow even while working. I failed in a lot of ways, but these principles have helped me. Talking about meetings, statistics have shown that we spend about 25% or more in our meetings every single day. We meet with people. People come into our offices, in our homes. One of the first principles of handling any form of meeting is to have an agenda. If you don't have an agenda, or if the person that is hosting the meeting doesn't have an agenda, have yours and ask very important question. What is the agenda for this meeting? Why? Remember your goal. Your goal is to get financially free and time free. You have your plan and how you're managing them. Get clear with the purpose of the meeting. The second principle is don't wait for a latecomer. My mentor once told me, he said, always act like the last person will never come. If a meeting is meant to start by 10, we should be here by 10. And if it's going to end by 11, it should end by 11. We shouldn't wait for somebody to come. It's clear terms. In your personal life, in that side business you're about to build. Because what? There's one thing and one thing you want to do. You want to manage time clearly. The next point, which is also very important, is chunks of time. I call this the gift of time. God has given us gifts of time. On Monday when you come to the office, guess what? You have a bit of time. You can come early to work, or you can take out the lunch time to get done with your goal and your business. Don't forget that principle. Or at the end of the day, you can stay back. At the commute, let me blow our minds. An average man spends about 12 miles per year on transit. Either going to the office, coming back from the office, either going to church, coming back from church, walking around. You know how much time that is? That is 12 to 25 work weeks in your lifespan. That's about 2 to 3 semesters of a school. That is to say, if you pick a goal and you spend out your time with the gift of time, you can become excellent in that field just managing time. Someone will ask me, why are you keen on the word management? You can't create time. You can't. Whether you like it or not, 12 midnight will come today. Whether you do those things you want to do or not. And if you can't create time, there's one thing you can do alone. You can manage time. One of the fundamentals to life development is management. We're going to talk about a few principles more, and I'll be out of your way. I'm sure we're taking down very important notes that will transform our lives. 2024 is coming to an end. We have more time. We think we will have less time. The next point, which is also important for time management, is time log. Time log. What time is it at the moment, and what am I doing with my time? Is that in accordance to my goal? Is that in accordance with the business I want to build in the future? Is that in accordance with my self-development? Look around. You could even assign somebody in my time. I said I want to start up a business in the next 6 months, on the next 6 weeks. Am I building my time well? Am I spending my time well? 11 o'clock, what are you doing? Are you on your phone? 12 o'clock, are you just gisting? A mentor once said, he said, if you look at your bank account, your balance every day, it's going to give you a subconscious anxiety towards building a career you want. Same way, if you look at your time log every day, it will build a subconscious identity in you. I don't waste my time, so I cannot spend time with you. Time log is very, very important. By 11 o'clock, what are you doing? By 12 o'clock, what are you doing? By 9 o'clock, what are you doing? Subconsciously catch yourself scrolling and write it down. This time I'm cooking. This time I'm playing. This time I'm working on my business. The tenth point, and which is also important, like I said, is neatness. You'd ask me, how is neatness important in time management? You know, one very interesting thing about life is the fact that most of us think we are smart. We think we are organized. We think we know what we are doing at every point. We think we have control, but you don't. Because if you look at your desk, if you look at your bed, is directly correlated to how much person you've become over time. If you take a sheet of paper, what's the first thing you do to those things? Do you just squeeze it and keep it? What we are doing today is to ensure that we don't waste time. But you know one thing? You cannot have a year and waste it. Why? Because every day counts. It means every week counts. And if every week counts, it means every month counts. And if every month counts, it means every year counts. That is to say, every second counts. The capacity of your brain that thinks you can remember everywhere, is that the same capacity you should use to invest in other things? Organize. For me personally, there's a principle I uphold while organizing. I call it the TRAF principle, T-R-A-F. The T stands for true. When you look at your desk at the office, anything you're not using now, you throw it. That's the first principle of time management. You throw it. You know, one very important thing about life is that most things we keep around ourselves are junk. That's why Pareto says the 80-20 principle. Anything you're not using, you throw it. The R stands for reach. Reach out to somebody. Can you help me do this? This thing has been on my table for a while. Please have a look at it. And the A stands for action. Work on it at the moment. If you can throw it, if you can give it to somebody, do it now. And the F stands for file. Keep it aside. You can't throw it. You can't give it to somebody to help you work on it. You can't work on it now. Put it inside a booklet. Keep it somewhere. And before you put it anywhere, ask yourself, if I lose this document now, would it affect me? And if it doesn't affect you, you go back to the T, you throw it. It's very important we either throw, reach out to people, we take actions, or we do what? Exactly. One of the most important things we have to take note in time management is interruptions. People are going to steal your time. You know, same way you cannot fling your money on the ground. Most of us today, we fling our time everywhere. Someone walks into your office. Can I just gist with you? Somebody said something today. Did you hear about it? One of the principles I do at the office, when someone is walking in and I know that person wants to steal my time, I stand up and I walk to the door. Oh, I was about to leave before you came in. Most people are there to steal your time. And guess what? Most of them don't even, they're not conscious of the fact that you sent the person away. Guess what? They move on to the next person and you're done. I walk back to the office and get done with my business. Why? I don't have time. Now, the consciousness of time management is the first step towards self-development. From that time to now, you can't be richer than him. And he said the first thing he does every day is to look for the thieves of his time. Who is that person stealing your time? Be very careful. If you cannot fling your money around, why fling your time? Most of us, if we have 1,000 naira in our pockets, we are very careful. But guess what? When someone walks into the door, you even sit down, relax. Maybe you're about to read the Bible, you're about to pray, you're about to call your family and friends. You sit down with the person, and guess what? 2 hours is gone. You're tired, you're exhausted. We call them energy drainers. There are some people that in your life that you must move. I won't call you to throw them away, but you have to relocate them. Why? Because of time management. Time management is life management. Time management is the management of tomorrow. Most of us here are products of how we use our time. You must have had children, or yourself, like a child, manage your time very well. With your family, with your friends, it's very important you manage your time. The next and the most important is to watch batch tasks. Time block your task. If I want to do something today, at this particular time, I will get it done. For things that look like that same thing, you cannot merge creative task with administrative task. Your creative task might be your business, your side business you are trying to work on during your free days. And your administrative task are the things you are doing at the office. Those two things are different. I always think about it. When I'm playing football, I'll be thinking about my office. When I'm at the office, I'll be thinking about football. Those two things are not possible. You batch task. When you come to the office, be at the office. Forget about the enjoyment at home. When you're at home, don't think about the office. They are two different things. Why? Because you want to batch create. If you think about what is at home, you'll not work effectively at the office. And if you're always thinking about what's happening at the office, you cannot work effectively at home. Time management, like I would say, is life management. I think I have two more points and I'll be out of your way. I'm sure most of us are wondering, why? Why do I have to manage my time? Why do I have to manage my time? If you don't manage your time, you will not manage your life. And if you don't manage your life, you can't manage destiny. How much you have today is directly proportional to what you've been investing your time into. Most times when we hear our fathers talk, we'll be amazed how much information these men have and they've built over time. You know what that's a cause or a result? Is how much they've used their time. They've used their time to study. They've used their time to learn. They've used their time to become who they are today. One beautiful thing about life is that something will always take your time. Either the right thing or the wrong thing. Something must take your time. You can't live in time without being conscious, because time is a slice of eternity. Time is a slice of forever. Forever is too much. So God decided to cut a piece and give you. He called it time. That's why there's a beginning and there's an end. So if there's a beginning and there's an end, that means you cannot live an unintentional life at the beginning and at the end. You have to be intentional every time, because you don't have control over it. You can only manage it. Two more points, like I said. You must say no. Always say no. Gift, let's go and eat. No. Gift, let's go and dance. No. Gift, let's go and watch the new movie. No. Be firm with your no. You know why? Most of us are just emotionally attached to people. That's why we can't say no. And that emotional attachment is what is holding us back from achieving destiny. If you waste 6 to 8 hours every single day of your life, when you are 30 years old, you've wasted 10 years already. Is that not scary? Always say no. He's a bad person. He doesn't want us to chill. Yes, I am. Why? Working on my business. Why? Because I can't say no. Please escort me. Let's go to Holy Ghost. The market. Let's go and buy something. No. Be firm with your no. It is very important to say no. It is very, very important to say no. Please, can you keep me company today? I feel bored. No. I can't. Why? Because I have a goal. I can't live forever. The best case scenario you have is 85, 90 at most, 100. Just think about how old you are now and think about how much you have in time and how efficient you have to say no. You've been saying yes all your life. How far has it brought you? It's time to say no. Please, let's go to this place. No. There's a new movie today. Now, the beautiful thing about life, I'm not saying you should say no to everybody, but like I told you initially, your priorities matter. And that's why I said, when you have a time at the office, we know that's the time at the office. You have your spare time, you also know that's your spare time. But be conscious and be very strong with saying no. Don't accept everything that comes. There's only one thing that accepts everything. You know what it's called? A trash can. And if you want to be a person of purpose and intentionality, you cannot be a trash can. You must reject some things. Your ability to say no is very important. The last point before I leave, somebody will be saying, you've said two more points. I think I have one more. Work simplification. There's always a way to do it because we want to manage time. There's a way to do it faster, more efficiently, better, easier. There's just a way. Figure out a way to work efficiently and simple all the tasks around. There's an increased rise in the use of technology today. There's an increased rise in the use of AI. Try as much as possible to implement these things in your daily activities. If it takes you 4 hours initially to write an article, with the use of AI and your personal prompts, your mindset, you could efficiently write that same article in an hour. Guess what? You've saved 3 hours. You can now use that 3 hours to work on your business or other things. Very important. Figure out ways that you can work better. Work longer, work faster, do things that are much more important. Get better every single day. Get better every single day. That is the only thing you should think about. Anything that would not make you become better, say no to that thing. How can I speak more fluently? How can I read more books? How can I be more confident? How can I articulate my thought process faster and better? Your ability to articulate your thought pattern in words is what makes an excellent man. The difference between a lazy man and an excellent man is how they manage their time. Most of us here are very creative. We have a lot of business ideas upstairs, but guess what? We cannot put them in words. You'll now say, I don't even know how to say it. There's always a way. At your spare time, figure that way out. Read books. Get a dictionary. Listen to men. Ask questions. Most of our fathers here and directors are very accessible. You could say, I need to learn this. How can I get this better? He might not know it, but he would definitely know someone that knows it. Or someone that knows someone that knows someone that knows it. Get better. 1.00 raised to the power of 20 is still 1. But 1.01 raised to the power of 20 is in thousands. You don't need to get better by 10%. You just need to get better by 1%. Start with 1 every day and you become that better person. I understand most of us have resources, have personal life, have individuals we are looking after. This is very, very careful. Time waits for no man. I said it before, you can't create time. You can only manage time. You can't control time. You can only manage time. Lastly, as you go home today, get your goals straight. Your personal goal, your family goal, your financial goal, very important. Money has a place to play in comfort. And get your self-development goals. Write it down on a piece of paper. An ancient scroll says, write it down, so that anyone that reads this will run. Write it on a piece of paper. It should be clear and defined. I want to make this amount of money. I want to achieve this with a deadline by the end of 2024. I have this and this to do every single day. Your goal, your actionable plan, very, very important. And lastly, be true to yourself. You can deceive any other person, but you cannot deceive yourself. If you're not managing your time effectively, you will know. And if you are managing your time effectively, you will know. The beautiful thing about life is that in the next 6 months or next year, we might meet again. We would now know clearly those that managed their time and those that did not. My name is Gift Mathias, and I want to thank the Directorate for this beautiful privilege. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.